Not in anything was once a beginner. Good morning, everyone. We, the students of Class 8Q, take this grand opportunity to heartily welcome Honorable MD Sir, Madam Principal, teachers and dear students to this phenomenal day of amusement and entertainment. The topic for our annual function is how the state government is constituted. Every great movement of God can be traced to a kneeling figure. To start by the name of God, the most gracious, the most merciful, the greatest thing that exists, ever has existed and ever will. For us to glory anything else would be a sin. As there is nothing greater than God, there is no calling greater than God. So please join your hands and close your eyes for the morning prayer.
Are the governments ruling the states of India, and Chief Minister heads the state government with the governor as the constitutional head. Power is divided between union and state government.
Local government works at basic level. It is the third level of the government after union and state government. It consists of panchayat in rural areas and municipalities in urban areas, elected directly or indirectly by the people.
India has a three-tier tax structure. The central levy tax, namely income tax, custom and excise, service tax, etc. The state government levies sales tax on entertainment profession, manufacture of alcohol, stamp duties on transfer of properties. Local government levies tax on property, charge for utilities, water supply, sewage, etc. The state and central government share the revenue between them.
Central government controls the matters under union list, such as defense, railways, atomic energy, oil fields, etc. State government controls the matters under state list, such as police order, public, health, water, etc. Both central and state government can make laws on matters under concurrent list, such as education, forest, weights and measures, etc. But in case of any conflict, the law of central prevails.
Governor is the chief executive head of the state, like the president. Appointed by the president, the office of the governor is an independent constitutional office. Chief minister is the de facto executive. Chief minister is appointed by the governor from the party who has attained majority in the state legislative assembly. When there is no clear majority, the governor appoints the leader of the largest party in the assembly as the chief minister and ask him to prove majority in the house within a month.
There is a council of minister with the chief minister to aid and advise the governor. The strength of the council of minister should not be above 15% of the total strength of the assembly, and minimum number should be 12. The chief minister selects a council of ministers who are then appointed by the governor.
Unicameral system consists of the governor and the legislative assembly. Bicameral system consists of the state legislative assembly, legislative council and the governor. Normal term of legislative assembly is 5 years, with the maximum strength at 500 and minimum at 60. Seats are reserved for scheduled caste and scheduled tribes also. Normal term of legislative council is 6 years, with maximum strength being 130 of the assembly and minimum being 40. 5/6 members are indirectly elected and 1/6 members are nominated by the governor. Speaker, deputy speaker, chairman and vice chairman are elected by the members from among themselves.
Election commission is a constitutional body. It has the power to conduct and regulate elections to parliament, state legislature, the office of president and vice president.
Representation of People's Act 1950 and 1951 lays down the norms and provisions of how the state government is constituted through elections. For holding direct elections of assembly, each state is divided into constituencies on the basis of ratio between the population of the state and number of seats allotted to it.
Notification of the election and last day for making nomination is given by the Election Commission. Scrutiny of the documents is done by the agents of Election Commission. Candidates also have an option to withdraw their candidature.
Election Commission allocates equitable sharing of time on the cable TV, electronic media and free electoral rolls. Parties go on campaigning to gather support. Election Commission fixes the day and time of polling, which is not less than 8 hours. Various counting agents, polling agents and turning officers are elected for the same.
Election Commission makes a list of voters. The eligible age for voting in India is 18 years and no voting is done by proxy. The finger of the person who has casted a vote is marked with an indelible ink to avoid personation.
Votes are counted in the presence of a returning officer and the results are declared by the same to the Chief Secretary of the Legislative Assembly. The party which secures half plus one or more than half number of seats is declared as winner.
The governor invites the member of majority party to form the government. Ultimately, the MLAs of all the parties meet in Legislative Assembly to discuss and resume the usual working of the government. The leader of the opposition in Legislative Assembly is the leader of the party who has secured second largest number of votes. Thank you.
Theater is a mirror, a sharp reflection of the society. The students of our class will now showcase a drama on how the entire mechanism of forming the state government works.
Act 1, Scene 1, Campaigning. The state of Rajasthan is going to elect a new chief minister in a month. The Election Commission has already declared the constituencies and announced the final list of candidates along with the date of polling. Model Code of Conduct has come into force in the entire state and will remain until the completion of voting. Its main purpose is to ensure that the ruling parties at the center and in the state do not misuse their position of advantage to gain an unfair edge. The government cannot lay new grounds for the project, cannot participate in the recruitment process. Ruling party cannot use its seats for campaigning purpose. There are three main political parties. Party A has a candidate Dushyant Kumar. Party B's candidate is Shubh Doda. Party C's candidate is Tanish Goyal and one independent candidate named Gayatri Sharma. The strength of the Legislative Assembly of the state is 200. Dushyant Kumar is a star campaigner of Party A, carrying on campaigning in constituency Sri Ganga Nagar.
Vote for Party A, vote for Dushyant Kumar, vote for Party A, vote for Dushyant Kumar.
Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. I have come here to my town to note with fellow townsmen and friends. Our party has been working tirelessly through ages to uplift and provide for common man. Our party and government has opened 12 medical colleges, 18 multi-speciality hospitals and 300 government schools. Friends, if you continue to give us the opportunity to serve you, we will serve you above your expectations. When the day of voting comes, request you all to vote for Party A. Your vote will decide the future of the state. Thank you.
Candidate of Party B and Party C have been going on the same spree gathering, support and mobilizing voters. Independent candidate Gayatri Sharma is also delivering speech in constituency Sri Ganga Nagar.
Dear all, today I have come here and stand before you to ask for your support in the coming elections. I have made sure that the people of my land do not remain devoid of the benefits that they very much have a claim on. In the last 5 years, me and my fellow compatriots have worked hard to uplift women and give them equal opportunities. The health and the insurance bill that was in limbo from a very long time was accepted by the central government because of the efforts of your able candidate. Ladies and the gentlemen, please go and vote on the day of the polling. Please vote for progress.
On the other hand, people of society, Sufet and Pandeen are discussing about who should they vote for. Mr. Karada, Mr. Pandit and Mr. Verma are discussing amongst themselves.
This party has been very diligent in uplifting the poor and marginalized sections. What do you feel?
Mr. Kalada, I think that Party A has been doing a lot for the state. Many hospitals and new schemes have been introduced by them.
I also agree with you, but I feel that if Party C is given a chance, it is surely going to deliver more. My family is very excited about who is going to win this time.
Act 2, Scene 2, Voting and Polling. The day of polling has come. Voting will take place in different phases. People have started gathering outside the wards where their names have been listed. The eligible age for voting is 18 years and above. Voting is going on at ward 20 of constituency Sri Ganga Nagar. Returning officers and election agents are present inside the ward where voting is done through electronic voting machines.
Your name and ID proof, sir.
Swastikarga, here's my ID proof.
Please sign here, sir. Right side, sir.
Please put your left and forefinger forward.
The EVM shows the party name, symbol and candidate with an option of none of the above and VVPAT visible for 7 seconds. One by one, all the voters exercise their voting rights. The voting is about to come to an end.
Gentlemen, the voting time is up. The Statute of Election Commission called for voting time to be from 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Please oblige.
Remaining voters go back as the mandates prescribed by the Election Commission cannot be tweaked. Act 3, Scene 3, Counting of Votes and Declaration of Result. Counting of votes is going to begin on the day notified by the Election Commission in District Headquarters. A strong room with the returning officer and election agents is designated for the same. Videography and media coverage is allowed inside the room.
You all have been given the details and guidance on how to do the counting. In case of any contradicting, paper audit trial will be considered final. Please take your seats and start the counting.
Have now been completed.
All the agents concerned are hereby instructed to seal the electronic voting machine and also fix the number of counting unit, date of poll and date of counting.
After hours, the result of election is ascertained by the returning officer and sent to Election Commission of India, Chief Electoral Office of State and Secretary of State Legislative Assembly.
We are here to declare the results of election to the Legislative Assembly from Sri Ganganagar constituency. First candidate, Dushyant Kumar of Party A, has received 8,65,000 votes. Second candidate, Shubh Doda of Party B, has received 6,15,000 votes. Third candidate, Tanish Goyal of Party C, has received 1,28,000 votes. Fourth candidate, Gayatri Sharma, independent, has received 1,89,000 votes. Total number of electors are 19,12,500. Total number of valid votes are 17,97,000. Total number of votes for none of the above 68,000. I declare that Dushyant Kumar of 2E165 Model Town has been duly elected to fill the seat.
Meeting of the winning party. The party A has attained majority in Legislative Assembly. They have won 107 seats. Meanwhile, the leaders of Party A, who have gathered for a meeting at Party Headquarters in Jaipur, have selected Mr. Dushyant Kumar as their leader. Mr. Dushyant Kumar is selecting the members of his cabinet, who have also won from different constituencies.
Please be seated. Congratulations to all present here for this huge victory. We now proceed to selecting the Council of Ministers. Mr. Rajiv Singh will handle irrigation. Dr. Vivek Sinha will handle education, arts, literature, and yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Local self-government, urban development, and housing will be handled by Hema Ramlal ji.
Yes, sir.
Prakshi Singh will handle forest and environmental.
Yes, sir.
Mahima Rathod will handle revenue.
Yes, sir.
Vikas Bishnoi will handle tribal development independent charge.
Yes, sir.
The members are invited by the governor to form the government. Third day after the governor's invitation has been selected as the oath administrating day. Act 5, Scene 5, Oath Ceremony.
Greetings and warm welcome to all who have gathered here for the oath-taking ceremony. I now invite Honorable Governor Shri Sartha Kapoor to administer the oaths of office and secrecy to the majority party leaders and members as the Chief Minister and Council of Ministers of Rajasthan.
I, Dushyant Kumar, to swear in the name of God that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Constitution as by law established, that I will uphold the sovereignty and integrity of India, that I will faithfully and conscientiously discharge my duties as the Minister for the State of Rajasthan, and that I will do right to all manner of people in accordance with the Constitution and the law without fear or favor, affection or ill will.
The government resumes the regular working in the Legislative Assembly. Basic principle that the government has to follow with regards to formulation of laws and its working is the directive principles of state policy. Their aim is to establish social and economic democracy through a welfare state under which citizens can lead a good life.
Everything in the universe has rhythm. Everything dances. Get ready for a high octane dose of divine worship. Make it a monster.
Vande Mataram, 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 V
now. God respects me when I work, but He loves me when I sing. Get ready for a beatboxing performance by Shubh and Saransh.
Give me some time to think. I'm in the bathroom looking at me. Face in the mirror is all I need. Out of a thousand men alive. My patience is waning. Is this entertaining? Our patience is waning. Is this entertaining?
for which we have no words. There are shortcuts for happiness and dancing is one of them. Steal yourself for a scintillating group dance performance.